Hello and welcome to Monmouth in Focus, a program about the services and functions of Monmouth County government. I'm Cynthia Scott, your host for Monmouth in Focus, and we are joined by Prosecutor Christopher Gramiccioni today. Thanks so much for joining us, Prosecutor.
Thank you for having me. Great to see you again, Cynthia.
Great to see you as well. Always a pleasure to have you here on Monmouth in Focus. And we're talking about the Special Needs Registry. It was unveiled this past spring. Very, very important program. And let's first talk about, you know, what it is and who it is for.
It's a no-cost voluntary service for special needs citizens who either live, work, or go to school in Monmouth County. Mm-hmm. That's a good summary of it.
Okay, and it's a voluntary program. Like you said, no cost. We want people to sign up. It benefits them if they sign up. What's the process?
Well, the process is, if they sign up, it's very, very simple. You can go to a web page to do that, or you can go down to a local police department or a library and someone can help you sign up from there. Mm-hmm. But the idea behind it is, if you ever might need a first responder, fire, police, EMS, or an emergency scenario or otherwise, it's designed to enhance the interaction that you might have with that first responder.
Absolutely. So if someone has special needs and you're not on the registry, a first responder may not have any idea, obviously, and they may have to react differently than if they were to stop you or your eye, so to speak.
And that's right. Remember those Saturday morning cartoons where they say knowledge is power? Mm-hmm. Well, the concept applies when you're a first responder. The more you know when you're responding to a site to help someone or a house or otherwise, the better treatment, the better condition that they can provide, the better handling of the situation they might be able to work through. So that's the idea behind it, is providing information about things like the nature of the disability or their name, their who's an emergency contact, their address, their age, who their treating physician might be, or what prescriptions mm-hmm. that they might take.
So when they go online and fill out the special needs registry, mm-hmm. obviously they can find the special needs registry on the prosecutor's office website, as well as visit monmouth.com, and they'll link you right up to it, as well as the Monmouth County Sheriff's Office website. But when they go online and look for this information, they fill out, like you said, all of the details, as much as they can about themselves. Does that then go to a police database? Does it go to the county database? How does that work?
That's exactly right. It goes to a confidential, law enforcement sensitive database that's administered by the Monmouth County Sheriff's Office. And that information is never accessed unless a first responder, like a police officer or somebody who's an EMS provider, would need to go to a home or to a site or otherwise. Mm-hmm. So there would be a flag on that person's account that's in that confidential database. And if there was a response there, it would pop up that they were a registered member of the Special Needs Registry, and then it would explain and provide access to all of this information. So as they're arriving on that scene, that first responder can review all of that and know who he or she is dealing with.
Right, right. So literally it could start with a 911 call in a mm-hmm. sense. The information would pop up with the name, or if there's an address there, and then they could dispatch the first responder and say, this person has diabetes, they need right. their insulin, this person is autistic, this person has Alzheimer's, correct?
That's exactly right, and it's designed to be really broad. We don't limit it to certain special needs. It's anyone who has a physical or mental disability that mm-hmm. might interfere with one or more life activities.
Absolutely, so it could be anything in any broad range of, we talk about autism a lot, but it's not just about an individual with autism, which is very important for them to mm-hmm. register, but it could be somebody that has one arm.
That's right, so as simple mm-hmm. as somebody who requires the services of a wheelchair or a walker, or mm-hmm. somebody that's oxygen dependent. Mm-hmm. Picture if a first responder arrived on scene, whether it's a policeman who's taken them out because, let's say, there's a flood or otherwise, or taking them to the hospital if they need treatment, they would want to know that they need to pick up a certain prescription medication or a right. tank of oxygen, or that they might need an electric wheelchair that they have to throw into the back of the ambulance mm-hmm. rig.
Mm-hmm. These are all life-saving techniques, too.
That's the idea behind it. It's just to provide a better service. We feel like we do a really good job, but there's always room for improvement. And having this information at the fingertips of first responders, we only hope that'll make it a better product.
How has the response been?
Really, really well. Early on, we had to go out and market it and advertise it because people were unfamiliar with it. But we now have over 500 registrants, and it's, like I mentioned, it's completely confidential and voluntary. People can decide to change their mind a week later if they like. But initially, there was some reticence because I think people were concerned over sharing such personal, right. private information. But we really reinforce the fact that it's completely confidential and nobody gets to see it unless a first responder needs to provide a service to them.
Sure, sure. Yeah, I would imagine the hardest part is signing up. Making that decision.
Yes, but when you actually decide to do it, the whole process takes under 3 minutes.
Yeah, exactly. Just putting in all your information is easy. Just make the decision and do it. And if maybe it'll never be used, hopefully, but it's there if you need it.
Well, we hope it never gets used. Mm-hmm. But when you look around at some of these incidents that unfortunately have occurred, like we saw out in Burbank, California, and down in North Carolina, there were police interactions with citizens who they learned after the fact had some kind of special need. Now, I'm not saying that if they had a registry in those states, maybe this could have been avoided. But again, that whole notion about knowledge giving power and helping with the process, we really subscribe to that. And we're really proud to be the first county in the country that's rolled this out across law enforcement countywide.
All right, Christopher Gramiccioni, Monmouth County Prosecutor, thanks so much for joining me.
Thank you.
And sharing such great information out there.
Thank you.
That's all the time we have for this segment of Monmouth in Focus. And of course, for more information about the Special Needs Registry, please go to www.visitmonmouth.com. I'm Cynthia Scott.